Alright, go. Right, that didn't go as planned. Alright guys, my video from yesterday, actually we spoke about how much heating you're going to use for which wheel. Today I'm going to show you how to do a tubeless wheel, tubeless conversion, going from tube to tubeless. So yeah, let's get cracking. Alright guys, the first thing you're going to have to look at when doing your wheel tubeless or converting to tubeless, it's something that I do. I'm not saying you have to do this. You can use the one tape for all the rims. But what I usually do is something like your Stans wheel or Eastern wheel or the rim. There's a different depth of the rim itself. The one that I'm going to use now actually has quite a deep rim, as you can see there. Yeah, if I had a Stans wheel, if you know, you know, if you don't, this is the wheel I'm going to use. The best advice I can give you is when using a Stans wheel, let me just see where I've put this, oh here it is. When using something like a Stans wheel, I'd advise you to use this yellow tape. I think it's also from, let's not say where it's from, but you can use the yellow tape. I'm not going to use it in this case because the yellow tape, it's more like a plastic texture, if I can say it like that. It's quite a hard tape. The one I'm going to use would be the Gorilla tape, and I think this is quite a good tape. You can use this on every rim, on a, like I said, on a Stans wheel with a it's a shallow rim on the inside actually, so you can use that plastic one. Otherwise, the one I'm going to use, let me just put you guys down here, I can show you. It's a tape, it looks like this. It's the Gorilla tape and it's nice and bendy. So you can, I hope you guys can see that. Anyway, that's what I'm going to use. That's just a little piece that I've had left from a previous wheel. So that's what I'm going to use on this wheel. It's a very, very good tape. A lot of people, they're not too satisfied with that, but I'm very satisfied with that. I'm going to use the Gorilla tape and I'm going to show you step by step how to do this. Yesterday, I was super excited for that surprise that I told you guys about. It didn't arrive at us yesterday, so I hope it comes today, then I'll show you guys. Otherwise, I'll do another video tomorrow with the install. I'll show you guys the big surprise. I'm super, super, super hyped about that. I can't wait to share that with you guys. Guys, Monkeying is really going somewhere. Check this out. So yeah, if you don't want to get left behind, please send me a message. We can ship these shirts. Well, at the moment in South Africa, I'll see if I can make a plan to get them overseas because I did have a request for one going overseas. Let's get Monkeying growing. I'm going to leave you guys with the challenge. Put it down in the comments below. What does MIA stand for? No, it's not missing in action. It's something to do with my logo and the brand. Let's get cracking. Alright, one of the first things I usually do is, you don't have to do this. I do this because it makes life a lot easier. When you've unpackaged or removed your tire from the box or the packaging that it's in, what I usually do is I get into a bit of sun. The heat usually helps to soften up the tire. So first thing I do is get the tire, get it into some sun, make sure it heats up quite nice. That will actually just help you to clinch the tire later when you have to put it on. I do this first because it's in the sun for a while and so you know it's nice or not. Alright guys, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to clean the rim. You can use some disc brake cleaner, some spirits, anything that'll clean everything off and not leave oily residue afterwards. So just make sure the oily residue, that's the main part, get everything off. I'm going to use some disc brake cleaner and yeah, let me show you how to do that. Alright guys, the things that we're going to need for this install, if I can say it like that, for the tubeless install, you'll probably need some tire levers. It's just sometimes it's difficult to get the tire over the rim. If not, you can just push it over with your thumbs. That's the first thing you're going to need. The second thing will be your tubeless valve. That's one of the more necessary ones. The other thing will be your Gorilla tape. That's the tubeless tape that I use. Your sealant, as I explained it to you in my previous video, so if you haven't seen that, just go check the previous video. I tell you what sealant I use and how much you can use it for that. And another thing you're going to do is now you're going to start, you're going to take your tubeless tape, you're going to find the valve hole on your rim. And what I usually do is, with the valve holes here, I usually move it about a quarter of the way around and then I start taping it there. So what you're going to do is you're going to put the start of your tape down, you're going to rub it nicely so you see it sticks everywhere, and then I pull it quite firmly and then I will stick it all the way around. Just remember, don't just stick it on there, do pull it a bit, make sure it's nice and tight when you pull it over. You can go two layers, I'm just going to do one layer for the purpose of this video, it should be fine, and two layers obviously better. But yeah, just put on your layer there and then you should be good to go for step two. Alright guys, basically for step three then, well, if you take step one of putting the tie in the sun as step one, otherwise step three, you've cleaned your rim, you've put on your tubeless tape. Step three, what you're going to do is you're going to take a small Allen key. I'd rather advise you to do that so you don't bend the valve core. Take a small Allen key, find your valve hole inside the rim, make a small hole with your Allen key, and then you can just push your valve through there. It shouldn't be too difficult. So yeah, let's do that. I've already made my small hole, so I'm just going to push my valve through as well. Make sure you've got all the extra rubbers. If your valve has extra rubbers on there, extra rubbers on there, make sure you've got all the rubbers on there. Otherwise, just put it on, push it through, and then take your little valve lock ring, that thing there. I don't know if it'll catch up on camera. Just take that there. Let's roll it up. And then one thing some guys do here that I don't really, I'm gonna say I'm not super positive about that, but don't tighten this too much. Remember, it must just hold the rubber in place. Tighten it with your hand as much as you can. Don't take a plier or anything to tighten this max out. So you do that, and the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put the tire on here. We're gonna throw in the sealant. Like I said on the previous video, I showed you guys how much sealant I use and how much sealant you can use. I almost thought this thing wasn't recording because this would have been the third time. Alright, then you would have seen how much sealant I use. I'm gonna put the tire on here. I'm gonna put the sealant in, make sure about the rotation on your tire. Put that on, put the sealant in. So I'm gonna, I'm not gonna show you these steps because it's quite easy. I'm gonna put the tire, I'm gonna put the sealant in, then I'll show you how to use your compressor to make sure you get it seated. And it started raining again. Alright, I know there's a lot of you guys hosing me out there now. Yaron, you're using a V-brake wheel. Yes, I know, but it's a double wall rim. I'll make a video about the different types of rim that you get. This is a double wall rim, so that's the reason I'm able to make this tubeless. So next I'm going to do the tire and the sealant quickly, and then I'll show you on the compressor how to inflate that and get it seated.
A few moments later.
Alright guys, I've installed the tire, the sealant I've thrown into my tire, the 150mm. Check the previous video, you'll know about all those things. Now there's two ways you can do this. You need a compressor. You can do it with a normal floor pump, it should work, but a compressor is just a lot better. So there's two ways you can do this. You can use a valve adapter, it's one of these brass little adapters. You can put that onto your valve and hope your compressor has enough air to actually fill that. That's what I'm going to do and hope for the best. Otherwise, what you can do is take one of these valve tools. This is actually from Park Tool. One of these little ones. Remove your valve core. The other thing is, if you remove the valve core, you're going to put the air straight into your valve without anything that's keeping it in there. So when you remove, you're going to keep it close with your finger. So when you remove your finger, you just need some lightning quick reflexes. Just put that in there. Screw it on and you should be good to go. I'm going to try the brass adapter first and let's see how it goes. Alright guys, what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin the wheel a bit. Just rotate it so you can get your sealant on every side of this tire. What that's going to do is it's going to make a nice little seal on the side of the tire and the rim. And at the moment I've inflated it, should give me enough airlock to get the tire seated. So let's try this quickly. This is method one I spoke about. So let's see if this works. Alright, so we're lucky this time. Otherwise, like I said, just use your blue valve tool and you should be good to go. Alright guys, I think that was a super easy install video. You should be able to do a tubeless wheel with that. If you still struggle, please send me a message or give me a comment down below. I'll make another video trying to explain it a bit better. But that's super easy. What I usually do is afterwards I've inflated the tire to get it seated. Make sure you see that it's seated all the way around. What I'll do is now I'll just put it into the bike or put it onto a stand where I can just spin the tire a bit so the sealant actually seals the whole thing, and I promise you, you shouldn't have any problems from there.